guys must find the Civil War stuff pretty interesting to stay 5 minutes late.
Believe I just did an involuntary fandango.
Mr. Tesco, how can I help you?
Actually, I wanted to speak with your father.
I'm sorry, I was just showing the class that history is full of surprises.
Original. At any rate, I can't seem to locate your father anywhere.
Oh, well, he's with my mom. They're in Washington. My mom's giving a speech on consumer rights.
Oh. Something has come up regarding Luke Brower.
Anatomy. Mr. Tedesco, when it comes to Luke, I'm pretty much second in command, so maybe I can help.
Don't tell me. The physics of trajectory.
No, they just don't like you. What about Luke?
The Bureau of Child Welfare has located Luke's natural father, George Brower. He's come to New York.
Really?
And he wants his son back.
Shakespeare, you'll love it.
I'd rather see this one.
It's raining guts? I'm not going to take you to see some gory, disgusting slasher movie.
It's either that one or Bambi Goes Dallas.
Okay, guts it is. Yes! Ladies and gentlemen, Ben Siever has entered the building! Yes, thank you, thank you. Hide the kids and lock up the goods.
We were just singing. Look at me. I'm as helpless as a kitten. Come on, Ben.
Okay.
Ben, listen to me. Luke's father is in town and he wants him back. Why didn't you tell him? Ben, I can't just tell him. I mean, the father leaves when he's 2 years old and doesn't show his face for 13 years? I'm not handing Luke over to this guy until I know he's absolutely perfect. Better call Dad. Don't you think I already tried that? There's no one at the hotel named Seaver. Well, then you just have to wait till they get back. I can't wait till they get back. His father could show up and take Luke away any second. And I have no idea how to find out anything about this guy. I do.
Luke!
What are you doing? You can't just ask him. You have to be very subtle about these kinds of things.
Mike wants to know all about your dad.
My dad?
He's all yours.
What about my dad?
Well, do you remember anything about him?
How could he? You just said the guy skipped out when he was two.
Well, I don't know much. All I know is he was involved in some kind of government work.
Really? Like, what are we talking here? CIA? FBI? USDA?
Yeah, the man was an undercover meat inspector. So your dad, he never made contact with you in all these years?
Well, he was some kind of secret agent. He was hiding with some witness relocation thing. He was trying to protect Mom and me. But I know somebody will come back for me.
Maybe sooner than you think.
We'll talk about this later. I'm in the middle of a Godzilla movie. He's got Tokyo between his toes.
Ben, what am I gonna do? I mean, if he finds out that his dad's in town, he's gonna go straight to him. He idolizes him. Hey, if our dad was a secret agent, I'd idolize him too. Get out of here, you heavy metal doorstop. I have to deal with this by myself. Your aunt's bass phone. Mom and Dad are gone, and for once, I can play as loud as I want. You want loud? Here's loud. Killed my amp.
Hi, may I speak with George Brower, please?
I really wish you could come with me today, Maggie. I hate being the only man on the wives' tour.
Well, I'm sorry, sweetie. I've got meetings all morning, and I give my speech this afternoon.
I don't know if I can stand another day of shopping and fashion shows. And by the way, those earrings are way too large for daywear.
Well, I guess you just have to bite the bullet and put in another day with the ladies. Speaking of which, what's on the agenda?
Well, highlights are the White House tour, lunch at the Smithsonian, and,
ooh, a complete makeover at Lady Be Lovely.
Who could ask for anything more?
Don't mock me, Maggie. If this weren't free, it would be downright humiliating.
Well, now you know how the other half lives. What about all the times I've gone with you to psychiatric conventions?
You never told me you didn't like the paranoia seminar?
I was afraid to. You've reached the voicemail for room 547. Maggie Malone is in a conference, and Jason Seaver is at a waterproof eyeliner seminar.
Oh, please, please, please don't let that be George.
Be right with you, George.
Excuse me, George?
We gotta salt that puppy down before stain. Honest, we need a couple of more napkins and make sure my compadre here gets a fresh slice of that Boston cream pie.
Hate Boston.
Okay, partner, we got you covered for dry cleaning. Our new shirt at the Spirit Moves. Gotta fly, big buddy. Catch you later on a midnight.
Oh, shut up.
10-4.
Thank you very much, but I still have to talk to that guy.
Not unless you want a belly button on both sides. I'm the George you want. You're Mike, right?
Yeah, you're George Brower.
Known and respected wherever hardworking men of the road stop to catch their breath and drink.
That's it. Shut up.
Coffee. Sit down.
Coffee? Made a fresh pot yesterday.
No thanks.
Sweetie pie, you have got the most breathtaking, gorgeous pair of hands I have ever seen. You didn't bring my boy, did you? You wanted to check me out first.
Breathtaking pair of hands? Does that kind of line really work?
Oh, from Tucson to Tupelo? Here, check out my brood.
Wow. These are all Luke's brothers and sisters?
Oh, half brothers and sisters. Don't get me wrong, I tried like heck to marry each and every one of their mamas, so help me God.
What stopped you?
There's something out there on that stretch of black between city and town that's bigger than life itself. The feel of the wind on your cheeks as your heart's pumping to the sun-drenched ecstasy of freedom. Sometimes you just have to scream out the window because it hurts so good. You know what I'm saying?
Sure, I kind of like when you eat ice cream too fast. It doesn't really sound like you need a kid to tie you down.
Oh, maybe these other little puppies might be a problem, but Luke's my firstborn. It's time for him to get out and scratch his name across the sky.
Look, I don't think you understand. See, Luke's in school now, and Luke's got friends.
I'm going to teach Luke things he can't learn inside four walls. He's going to make friends all over this country.
I don't know.
Look, Luke's my son. Either you bring him to me, or I get an attorney. Either way, I get it. So have him back here by 7:30 tonight. And we get to stay buddies.
Hey, Mike, where were you? You said you'd be back before lunch. Hey, what's that all about?
I just want to give you a hug, you little knucklehead.
Mike, if you're trying to thank me for doing your math homework, I'd rather have money.
Hey, come on, can't you give another guy a hug without everybody getting the heebie-jeebies?
No.
Hey, what's the matter?
Mike, be honest. Would you go to the movies dressed like this?
No. Petticoats make me look hippie.
Harold, this. She made me look like a geek.
Hey, consider yourself lucky. You should have seen what she used to do to Ben.
Oh, my bum.
Yeah, me too.
Ready, precious?
Hey, Carol, look, I really need your help.
If you only knew how long I have been waiting to hear those words, Carol, I need your help. And now that I've heard them...
Seriously, I'm trying to get a hold of Mom and Dad. And I called the hotel and there's nobody registered under Steve.
Well, did you try under Malone, you Neanderthal?
Malone? Carol, I'm going to show you what a stupid idea that is, okay?